Okay, everybody, it's currently 2:16 a.m. and we just had the Coast Guard leave. Earlier today, we went to pull up our anchor and found it wrapped around a 12-inch piece of pipe with another piece of pipe on it, another piece of pipe on it. Needless to say, it had cut 3/4 of the way through our 1¼-inch anchor rope, and we were a little worried, and so I called Boats US, who came out, helped us cut, well, they didn't help us cut it loose, but they recovered our anchor for us, and then proceeded to leave, because we thought we had a good running motor and everything, and a clean prop. Well, it had been just about 3 to 4 weeks since the last time we had our prop cleaned. And apparently the shit grows here really fast. When we tried to put it in gear and move, when we cut this big piece of pipe loose, it wasn't happening. So, we threw out a temporary anchor and hung for a little bit. And then I got a weather warning. Severe thunderstorms were coming. I only saw a couple flashes of lightning, but the winds were 30, 35 knots, and they come up out of nowhere. We drug anchor about, I'd say, 200 yards and ended up against some pilings that had just pipe, you know, big 2-foot around pipe that had just been driven into the bottom by a construction crew. So while we were on the side of these pilings, we were getting bashed against the pilings by 3 to 5 foot waves. But I'll be honest with you, I was scared shitless. Had to go change my pants after everything was over. But we survived. Right as I called the mayday, they sent the Coast Guard out, and just as I heard that they were sending a small boat out to try and help us, we got off the pilings, and we drifted a little ways, and I mean, the rain was sideways. We had tried to hacksaw off part of the bowsprit pole, because it was keeping us from getting off the poles. It had caught us. The wind was blowing one way and the waves were coming from another, so we were kind of stuck against these poles. So at the last minute, the wind started to change direction, and the piece of pipe off the bowsprit that had been keeping us from going suddenly got bent down, and we started sliding back. During that time, we also broke our radar off our rear mount that Kim had made, so we have to rebuild that. But luckily it fell right into the dinghy, which was apparently her plan. I was unaware of this, but she said she planned it that way. Since it happened that way, I'll buy it. So anyway, thank God for that. Anyway, the dinghy took a bad hit on one of the pilings, both front and rear. And then we were able to push off the pilings when the wind changed, and we drifted back and away from the pilings. When we got to a certain point, we had reattached our anchor to a cleat and was ready to go, and we threw it overboard. So, and at that point, the Coast Guard had already dispatched a patrol boat to check on us. Even though I had called them and told them that we were okay, they were coming to check on us anyway, which doesn't surprise me. They have to fill out their paperwork every time somebody calls a mayday. So, of course, they wanted to see my navigation rules book. They wanted to see my fire extinguisher, my flares, some kind of whistle or a horn, of which I had both. They didn't come on board, especially because they saw the dogs. I think that was the main reason they stayed on board their own boat. And they just wrote me off a thing saying my vessel had been inspected and I passed inspection. Had all the everything they wanted to see, my ownership paperwork, my passport, which is all the ID I have right now. So that was good. So we're currently at anchor. The winds have died down to almost nothing now. I'm going to go over here to the chart plotter. Whoop, I lost my balance. And we're going to, there's our chart. That, see, it broke off right there at midnight. We had a long trail going up above it, but this is us right now. That's our boat. So now we'll go over here to our instruments. Yep, almost dead calm, 1.4 knots, 1.3 knots. We have 9.2 volts, so we better shut off some power. I'm shutting off your light, Kimmy.
No, leave it on. I need that if I need it.
I'm going to shut off my room light. So anyway, we're okay. Hopefully we'll have a nice day tomorrow and we can charge up our batteries with the solar panels again. So the light's going to go off here, so it's going to get dark. Oh no. So anyway, we're okay. Dogs are okay. Boat took a beating, broke up some teak rails, but we're okay. The teak can be replaced.
Bowsprit's strong as hell.
Bowsprit's strong as hell. I got to give that thing credit. Without that thing holding on, it'd have gotten ripped off and we'd have gone through the pilings and probably got hit by the bridge and busted off the mast and all that stuff. So it's been a real eventful night.
Both in the basket at the same time. Yeah. She was holding a buoy between.
I was holding a buoy, and Kimmy was trying to hacksaw the pipe off, which eventually bought, ended up getting bent down, and that's how we got off. Yeah, she tried hitting it with our 12-pound maul, and it didn't budge. It was cut halfway through. That is some strong pipe. I will give that shit credit. That took a beating, and it never gave. Thank God it gave way when it did, so that we got off those pilings, or we'd probably still be there. The boat was, you could hear things creaking and cracking, and, I'll have to check out the boat in the morning. But again, yeah, we had at least 4-foot to 5-foot waves. It was quite the shit storm. There's my Seahawks. 3-0. Woohoo! That's about all we got to be happy about right now. And that we're okay. Boat's not taking on water. We didn't break anything life-threatening. So, everything's good. I see our solar lights outside are blinking. So that means it got water inside it. And so it'll be blinking until it dries out. So, anyway. We'll see y'all later. Oh, shit. Bye. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Who knows what else is next? Bye-bye.